I am happy with the results the grading optimization has given me, but now I would like to incorporate my detention pond in with my grading. This is straightforward. I need to adjust my grading limit zone to include the area I want my pond to be added, and I need to define my detention pond. The dark blue polyline has been drawn to represent my pond. I will apply the pond grading object to that polyline and then modify the options of the pond properties. One of the pond properties that we will change is the minimum storage volume. This is a great feature because the solver will size the pond for that particular volume. No more iterating back and forth to get the desired volume. We also will set the max storage depth. In this case, we will use 4 feet. You can also add in a safety bench inside of your pond. This would probably apply to a much deeper pond, but you have that option. You can also define the berm width, how much freeboard you would like to have above and beyond your pond volume, and you can control the inside slope of the pond. One last setting we need to consider is allow boundary change. What this means is that the rectangle we have defined for the pond, do we want the solver to adjust the size of the envelope automatically? In this case, it is on, but we should toggle it off. To control the slope of the ground from the parking area to the pond, we will create a zone to connect them. We will add this because I am controlling the water in the parking lot with inlets, so the water will be flowing to those inlets. I want to sheet flow the water from the back of the parking directly into the pond. We will add the zone grading object to the newly created polyline representing the area between the parking and the pond. We will need to toggle on slopes and set the min slope to 5% and the max slope to 33%. We will also use something new in this zone. We will set the minimum inclination. This setting allows us to set a direction that the solver will grade. The inclination direction uses AutoCAD angles, meaning that 0 is east, 90 is north, 180 is west, and 270 is south. I'll take a shot at this angle and call it 235 degrees and see how that looks. The last thing we need to do before we run the optimization is set a low point inside the pond so the grading optimization will know where it is draining the pond. We will simply manually place a Civil 3D point at the location of the outlet structure first. We will select the point we just added, defining it with the low point grading object. I will rename the low point so that it will be easily recognized when we optimize. Now we are ready to rerun the optimization, and the detention pond will also be created in our model. One thing I would like to point out, remember when we ran the optimization the first time without the pond? We reset some of the colors of the grading objects. The color changes held when we sent the optimization back to Civil 3D. These colors held once more when we selected Optimize. You can see the color of the building, the sidewalk, and the curb, that it's easier to see them, and that's what we wanted. Once again, we need to take a quick look at the order of the zones in the tree. Remember, the zone that is being used for the grading limit needs to be at the bottom. We added another zone for the grading between the parking and the pond, so it will need to be moved above the grading limit. We also need to be sure that the two zones for the truck well are in the right order. The outside zone needs to be set below the inside zone representing the inside of the truck well. Taking another look at the pond, we need to toggle allow boundary change off in this instance. Before optimizing, always check the model settings to be sure that the mesh quality is set to low for performance, and then take one last look at the global options to ensure that they are set the way you want. With all settings reviewed, we're ready to optimize. You can see that quickly the detention pond is taking shape, and the truck well is starting to be carved out. We can take a look at the convergence plot to be sure that the blue line in the feasibility graph is making its way to the bottom of the graph. If this line starts to turn horizontal, you know that there's a setting on one or multiple grading objects that might not be able to be achieved. At that point, you can stop the optimization and start to interrogate the grading objects and then simply optimize again. One last check of the convergence plot shows me that we're getting very close to a solution. So I am ready to stop the optimization and send the results to Civil 3D. Again, we will toggle off feature lines and points and have it create a new surface called Design with Pond. So at the end of the day, grading optimization has created three different surfaces for us: the mass grading surface, the design without the pond, and then the design with the pond.